Hey guys, this video is going to cover the common operating features of TESmart's 4-computer, 2-monitor KVM. Here's a list of the topics that we're going to cover, so if you want to jump to those, you can use the links in the description. Let's kick off with this resolution refresh rate chart. With HDMI 2.0 compliance, you can enjoy stunning 4K resolution at 60 Hz. Once you go lower in resolution, you can take advantage of the increased bandwidth and get even higher refresh rates. Our customers are often looking for 1440p at 144 Hz or 1080p at 240 Hz, and this KVM delivers on both. The monitor settings work independently, so you can have one resolution with a high refresh rate, and then the other monitor can have a standard resolution with a standard refresh rate, or both can be at the high refresh rates if you want them. Now let's talk about the hotkey functionality. To take full advantage of this feature, make sure your keyboard is plugged into the dedicated mouse and keyboard ports. You can use wired or wireless devices, it doesn't matter. These ports use emulation to intercept and convert keystrokes into hotkey commands. So by using scroll lock or the right control key, you can easily switch inputs with just a few key presses. For example, scroll 2 will take you to computer 2, and scroll 4 will take you to computer 4. You can even turn off the buzzer with scroll F11 or activate auto switching with scroll spacebar. To change the auto switching interval, scroll plus for more time or scroll minus for less, you can also adjust the time interval by pressing the minute and second buttons in the front of the KVM. All you have to do is adjust the time and then press set to enter that time. And if you want to get out of auto switching mode, just press escape. If your keyboard doesn't have a scroll lock key like most all Mac keyboards, then you can swap the hotkey trigger from scroll lock to right control. All you have to do is press and hold the set button on the front of the KVM until it beeps, and then restart it. This KVM is unique in that it allows you to independently control each monitor using the front push buttons on the KVM. Want computer 4 on monitor 1 and computer 1 on the other? No problem. Just press output A, 4, and then press output B, 1. And then you can even switch which computer the mouse and keyboard are allocated to by double tapping right alt. And if you really prefer to use a remote control, all the same functionality is available. The M button is output A and the P button is output B, or you can just press the input number on the remote to switch both monitors at the same time. The peripheral I/O of the KVM includes two mini audio jacks for speakers or headphones. One is in the front and the other is in the back. We connected some speakers in the back, some headphones in the front, and a webcam in the USB hub. Let's run through how to make sure Windows knows which devices to use. Okay, so we're here in our desktop environment, and we're going to right-click on the little speaker icon in the tray and open sound settings. Now here we're going to choose our output and our input device. The input device is really easy. We're using a little Blue Yeti microphone, so we'll select that. The output device is going to be the name of your monitor. And the reason that is the computer will send signal to the KVM, which then will replicate that signal to the mini jack in the back, the mini jack in the front, and then also your monitor. So at this moment in time, we actually have a pair of speakers plugged into the back, a pair of headphones into the front, and then we have our monitor. So we're gonna select that here. Now let's go ahead and go into Zoom, and let's check all of our devices. Go to video, and we're here with the video, and come down to audio. We'll test our microphone, check, check. Test our microphone, check, check. That's working okay. Let's test our speaker. And there's our speaker. One last note is if you don't see the name of your monitor in the list of output devices, then select the one that says ITE HD. And as a worst troubleshooting step, if you don't see any of the ITE or the name of your monitor, just try all the different outputs that are there. One of them is eventually going to work. All right, and that's it. As you can see in the back here, there's a green port for sending serial commands to the KVM. To connect a computer and send serial commands, you're going to need a program like CommWatch. Then, to connect the computer, you're going to need a cable like this that has a Phoenix to RS-232 adapter, and then another cable that has a RS-232 to USB adapter. We aren't really going to go into this today because, honestly, this type of setup is pretty rare, and it's really only used for control programs like Control 4 or Savant. But if you want us to dive deeper, go ahead and leave us a comment, and then we'll get into it. The last two features are the infrared remote control extension and the DCCI port. The IR extender is simply plug and play. Just connect the included extension cable to extend the range of the remote control, very simple. And as for the DCCI port, well, that's used to cascade two of these KVMs together and send commands to both KVMs at the same time. So for the last video in this series, we're going to demonstrate using the DCCI port in two of these KVMs to run a quad monitor setup. It's pretty cool and definitely recommend checking it out. All right, that's it for today. Thank you guys and have a great day.